We've been staying in beautiful beachfront resorts these past days, but it's time for a change of scenery. Today, we're exploring Bohol's great outdoors.
Yep, this paradise is not just about the sea. Bohol also boasts spectacular hills and mountains.
Thank you.
Welcome. Oof. Fresh air. Okay, so here we are at Camp Charlie in Gindulman Bohol.
That's right. Looks like a great change of scenery after the beach. Can't wait to enjoy the great outdoors.
All right, so I think they're setting up camp just up on that hill over there, so let's go check it out.
So here we are with miles of sea and land adventure. Tell us, how did you guys get this whole thing started?
Well, initially it was Martin's idea. He wanted to do something different. Because of the pandemic, everybody started looking for other things to do. Mm-hmm. You know, the normal, when you go to Bohol, you go to the tourist destinations, and it's just too
saturated.
Yeah. So we looked for different locations, different mm-hmm. places around Bohol, where technically not a lot of people go to. Mm-hmm. And since then it started, and we've been looking and investing in equipment.
Wow, really cool. What made you set out on this exact location or this hillside with this view?
You know, our locations technically have different views, different experiences, and that's basically how we, you know, we want to let people know that Bohol has so many other things to do, mm-hmm. so many places to go to. This one, we like it because it's like, it's got a 360 degree. It also has a nice view at night. So if you like stargazing.
Love stars. Tell us, yeah, what is so special about camping?
Camping is like a picnic where people get together. You get to know each one, you spend quality time with them. You learn from different things.
You guys rely on each other and it becomes very community-based. Like we saw earlier, we pitch our tents together. We're gonna eat together.
Cook together.
Cook together, nap near each other, wake up to each other. So you get a sense of camaraderie and community.
Correct.
And you make bonds that I'm sure, and friendships that will last forever.
We like to share our experiences. You know, we're also from the city. I left Manila because it's too busy, so, you know, I know that this is something that a lot of people from the city, the big city, would mm-hmm. love to. I think this is the perfect maybe getaway.
Yeah. And getting back to basics. Digital detox.
Yes.
No Wi-Fi is the new luxury, they say.
Yep.
Well, we are then in the lap of luxury.
Yes.
Miles, thank you so much for, first of all, putting this whole thing together, sea and land adventure, and giving people the option to do that and seeing another side of Bohol.
Yeah.
And also for bringing us here to your little square of paradise. So, I don't really camp very often, but I do have some stuff that I figured was essential. Number one, of course, is a water bottle. Very, very important. Number two, charger. Number three, headlamp. Red light, white light, brighter light. Hopefully, I will never need this. Raincoat. A silk sleeping sack. I didn't bring a sleeping bag, but I think we might have some. But sleeping sack, if in cool weather and in warm weather, it thermoregulates, so it's very handy. And if you're staying in hostels or anything, you can use this if you don't trust the beds, mattresses, or bed sheets, because bed bugs can't get through silk. I have my cutlery set, fork, spoon, chopsticks, and steel straw. Also got a pair of thermals in there, just in case it gets really, really cold, I can put them underneath my pants. And toothbrush, toothpaste. That's about it. That is my camping gear. Oh, one last thing. I also happen to pack a view. Never leave home without it.
So this is gonna be my home for the night. I love the setup. As you can see, I made sure to face our openings. This is a two-door tent, but my main opening toward the best view, overlooking the mountainside and the sea from a different vantage point than we're used to seeing. What's good about camping is that you're one with nature. When you do go camping, you want to make sure that you bring chairs like this, something portable, something easy to assemble. When I go camping with my dog and my fiance, I like to bring tables, just some simple stuff that you could cook and eat. And the whole point is to be used to being good with bare necessities, getting used to just relying on yourself. Very minimalist, simplistic, non-materialistic, and basking in nature. So guys, this is what it's all about. Being one with the elements. It's pitch black outside. We've got some help of some solar camp lights.
Mm-hmm. And of course, the fire of the barbecue. And most importantly, we have excellent company.
This island is the perfect spot for snorkeling, free diving, and scuba diving.
To make the most of our trip here, we're going to do both free diving and scuba diving. Balikasag Island, one of the top reasons people come to Bohol, and maybe even one of the top reasons people come to the Philippines. Well, divers especially. It's always been high on any scuba diver's list to visit this place, and there's a very good reason why. The drop-off walls are absolutely stunning. Just the structure of all the corals, and the sea turtles here are plentiful and they're friendly. And for someone who's a turtle lover like me, it is pure bliss.
Every time I come back to Bohol, I fall more and more in love with it. Most especially because of my visits to Balikasag Island. They have some of the best free diving and scuba diving spots that can be found anywhere in the Philippines.
So we're here now at Bohol Beach Club, and we're going to meet up with our good friend, Martin Zapata, who is our national record holder for free diving and also probably one of the best underwater photographers and editors you could possibly find. So he's going to help us get a little bit better at our free diving.
Yes.
And hopefully take some nice images of us as well. Hey Martin, what do you have in store for us?
So we will be diving here at the house reef of Bohol Beach Club.
Mm-hmm. All right. What do you have planned?
We'll do a photo shoot.
Mm-hmm.
Just fun diving.
All right,
okay, we'll just cool. Enjoy the water.
And we a little like crash course in free diving, right?
We can do that also.
Okay.
All right. Okay, well, shall we get our gear set up and maybe you can give Christy some extra pointers?
Just when you swim, try not to paddle with your hands.
Okay.
Expectations for this dive is to get wet. I'm pretty confident about that.
Just excited to get back in the water.
Let's do this.
Here we go.
How was your free diving sesh?
Well, after another crash course, it just feels really good to be in the water. and like I mentioned, to be one with the sea. It's so clear down there, so many beautiful corals. How was yours?
Ah, it was awesome. It's always a little bit more challenging when you're doing a photo shoot, especially when Martin says, okay, no weight belt, no snorkel, like all my comfort zone things when I free dive. Exhaling everything to stay down on the bottom.
We already talked about that before, that's one of my biggest challenges. I feel much more comfortable holding my breath in, but yeah, when you have to release everything that you have in order to sink, that's definitely a challenge. But I was definitely pushing it today, and I hope the pictures came out excellent.
I think that modeling underwater is a completely different area of freediving. How to hold your breath, how to maintain a position, how to exhale, how to not use all of your usual acquirements.
Totally. The dynamics are totally different. You need to learn how to position your body in ways that you're uncomfortable with. And you have fins as well, so it's another additional challenge in order to make sure your fins look graceful, your arms, and your face. It's definitely difficult to look flattering while you're holding your breath. So, but regardless, I think the backdrop is what makes the photos the most magical, because there's no other element as beautiful as the sea.